So yeah, hello everyone. As Benoît said, I work at itwas.lu, and malware.lu is right on my t-shirt. So most of my job consists to do malware analysis on some client in the Luxembourg country, and I made also some penetration testing sometimes, and I like to play CTF, like AKLU CTF or WhoTMe or whatever. I am also part of the staff of WhoTMe. A few years ago, I made some challenge at WhoTMe. And I'm also a Zitologue. I like this word because it's kind of like a scientific word, but that just mean I like beer. It's a joke. So as you probably already heard, I am not English fluent, I'm French, so sorry about that. So excuse me if I made some English mistake, some conjugation problem in grammar. So I try to be more fluent, so that's one of the reasons that I made this talk. I want to improve my English. So first, I start a few years ago to see what's happened on my internet connection, my private internet connection. I want to understand what there is inside the internet, what come from the internet to my home. I put some start by a firewall that and see what's happened in the log. And after, I want to go deeper, so I have installed an epot. Like I have started by Diania. I don't know if someone know that. It's an epot who emulates some a lot of services like NFS, RDP, or whatever, HTTP, and all the lot of protocol, and catch some malware. It catch some malware. And after, I have tried to. I have installed another epot, SSH. On a pot, it's called Kipo. It's an old one, very old one. The project is ending now, but a few years ago, some people made a fork of this Kipo, this Kipo program. It's called Cori, and it's very very nice. It emulates SSH like Kipo and Telnet. So this one, you can catch some malware. Do try to brute force your SSH connection, SSH client. Server, excuse me, and Telnet server, and some attacker try to drop some malware inside. So that's the behavior of most of well-known malware on Mirai and other DDoS. So we will see what's happen if we do some of this one. So yeah, as I already say, I have installed an epot. I have buy it's not a little expensive. I buy just a Raspberry Pi. It cost for 30 euro, and install Cori. It's easy to install, and it's hard to see, but here you can saw the log. You can see the log from a Mirai attack. It try to some pass some command inside your onepot, and it try to identify it's a real onepot or it's a real server. It pass some echo command, and it's easy to learn the onepot. You have to configure Cori a bit. To learn Mirai, to think Mirai is not on, inside the onepot. It's easy. You are just to copy the echo binary inside the Cori, so it's easy. And after you can catch some malware. So yeah, you can install Cori from the Kipo repository. Just made a Git clone, so it's fast and easy. Easy to configure. You are just to put some fake credential inside the Cori configuration, like root and password root, and you will find a malware in a few minutes after. Really, a few minutes. There is a lot of attack. And with keep Cori, because Cori is a fork of Kipo, so you can use old Kipo tool like KipoGraph. It's a web interface. I forget to say, Kipo log can log all this log inside MySQL DB. And you configure after Kipo web server to access to the web to the MySQL DB, and it made a lot of cool graph. Like you see, there is a lot of There is a graph about credential testing on your nepot, like root 54321, admin. It's a credential test by some botnet. And there is a graph of number of attacks. You can see there is a 4,000 attack in one day. So there is a lot of attacks. It's just on my first nepot on my home. So imagine if you put on a nepot on, I don't know, China, for example, or Russia. That's I made after, because I have just one on nepot at the beginning, so I have catch some malware, but I want to go deeper, so I wanted to install a lot of on nepot inside the internet. At this time, I have 3 on nepot, so only, but 2 years ago, I have 10 on nepot, and because it cost a lot. So now I have a few nepot. So I will try to install new nepot after. I will talk about it after. So as I already say, we find some Mirai and Xor DDoS and Gegift malware. So it's the most common malware on Linux. And Mirai source code was leaked. I don't remember. I think it's 2 years ago on a hacking forum. So the source code, everyone can get it. So there is a lot of fork of Mirai, like Hachimi. And it's a malware. I find it's the most used malware. I think Hachimi is one of the more complicated malware because it's the only one I have found it's packed. I say complicated, but it's not really trust because malware on Linux are really technically low. So it's easy to install, so it's easy to reverse, sorry. So if you are not fluent in reverse engineering, you can improve your skill with the malware on Linux. It's easy, it's really easy to reverse. Most of the time, a string command line, it's sufficient, really. One of the more interesting malware, it's of course Hajime, Mirai, and Xor DDoS. Xor DDoS, I think it's really interesting because if you don't know a lot of malware, you can reverse it and you can learn some things. So, as I say, at first time I went just on nepot, so I catch a lot of malware, but always the same. So I wanted to install a lot of on nepot on internet, in China, Singapore, Amsterdam, and whatever. But after that, you have to install Cori, buy a server, and what else. But it was hard to follow. You have 10 on nepot, you have to follow 10 interface, 10 you have to see 10 different logs. So it was really boring. I searched a way to aggregate all the log and follow my logs in one interface. And I'm on IRC2 and like a radar IRC or whatever Zershan, and some friends are interested to reverse some malware, so they ask me to if I can give them some sample. So I have to go to inside to my nepot, download the malware and send the malware to my friend. So it's not boring, but there is better easy way to do that. So I start to thinking to another way to aggregate all the thing and a way where I can share what I find. So and all the malware most of the malware are the same. So it's not really interesting to reverse all the malware. So it must be automated. So I have start to scrap. I made a script to automate the reversing of the malware, like for the DDoS malware. It's easy, you have just to make a Xor in Python script. So it takes 5 minutes. And as I said, I have used Radar 2 to make my reverse of the malware. Radar is a framework, a reverse engineering framework. You can install it easily. You can use it on Windows, Linux, Mac OS, everywhere. It can reverse a lot of architecture like Intel, 64 bytes, ARM, MIPS, you can, some, I know some people try to reverse firmware from a satellite. You can run it on Apple Watch, yeah. So it's really a big reverse engineering firmware. You can do a lot of things with that. You can make exploit with that. You can search for rogue gadget, and I use it for malware analysis, of course. And you can script malware. You can script reversing and, with a R2 pipe. It's a Python module for radar. And so as I say, I have automate Zordidos analysis. So we don't see very well. It's dark here. But here it's a capture of radar. It's a CLI capture. So it's a graph. Yeah, you don't see it well because here you have the XOR key and there is a loop, and it decrypts a byte array with the XOR loop. I will show you. There is a new interface for radar because radar is a GUI software, so you use it inside the command line. But there is a new project. It's a graphical interface for radar. It's called Cutter. I want to show you. Yeah, I have opened the XOR sample inside the Cutter, and as you can see here, it's the XOR key. It's always the same. The malware is very old. The first time we saw XOR DDoS, maybe it's 5 years ago. And it's always the same. The XOR key is always the same. The developer of the malware haven't changed nothing inside the malware. So if you click on the XOR key, up here. Now, it's better finding, I think. You can see the XOR key is here. So it's moved inside the EAX register. And you can see a loop. And there is a XOR here. Here in EDX. Maybe upper. Oops. What the? Oui, fait ça. Ah. So in EDX, he put the address of the byte array, and there is a XOR loop, and it decrypts the byte array. Inside the byte array, there is a CC address. So it's not really a big technical stuff. But as I already said, in malware Linux, it's not really, really technical hard. So if you can use a Cutter, it's disponible from the GitHub repository, but it's not stable. It's a project that started a few years ago, so try it, but if it crashes, don't be afraid. It's normal. It's in beta test for the moment. I think there will be a release soon, maybe in 1 or 2 months. Go back to the PowerPoint. Yeah. So. After that, so I made some Python script to reverse some malware like XOR DDoS and Mirai with the help of the friend. I'm not the only one who made this script. Maxime Morin helped me a lot. It's one of the developers of the radar project. So and we have the idea to use a bot to help us to follow my bot, my honeypot. And reversing of the some malware. So this is the radar logo, the Python, because we use the both. And with my friend, we talk a lot of from on IRC and Telegram, more now inside Telegram. So the idea is to use the bot inside the chat room where we discuss on Telegram. So for that, we use a ARBot. It's also a project inside the GitHub. It's a bot coded in Python 3. And we use Tor to download our malware sample to be to have some kind of anonymously. And so how to create a bot? First, you connect to the Telegram, you made an account for inside Telegram, it's easy. But after you want to create a bot, you have, there is a bot to create a bot. So it's called a bot father. So you have to talk with a bot father. You say to him, oh, I want to create a new bot. You send the command, the new bot, and it will ask you for the name of the your bot you want to create. And it will return, it will give you a token, ID. This token ID, save it, and you will have to use in the RRBot configuration. So RRBot, as I say, it's already easy to install. You have just to make a pip install RRBot, a pip free install RRBot, because it's Python free. And you can see RRBot support a lot of chat protocol. You can use it inside Telegram, IRC, HipChat, Slack, Google Talk, what else? It's really, really useful bot. And you can connect your bot on the Telegram and also in IRC in the same time. So it's really cool. So as I said, to install, you have to just this line, this command line. Don't forget RBot init. It will create the configuration file. And there is an example of an empty configuration file. Here you can put your token ID returned by bot father. Here you put some data it's used for bot during the bot is launched. And here you put your plugins. It's important because it's here you put your personal plugin. And after you put another token for an ID. So yeah. So I have made some plugin on Telegram for on my all my own iPod. I use a PHP script which read my database where the log of Cory is stored, and it export all the log on inside the JSON on the JSON format, and my bot pass all this PHP script and read the JSON format. Save it in the another MySQL DB, and after if he parse the log parse the log, and if he checks the sample is no already no, and if he find a new sample, he send me a message. Oh, you see, as you can see, new malware is fine. It's a drop side address here. The it put the name of the sample, it passed the sample to the YARA rules, and the YARA rule return the type of sample and return to the MD5 the sample. It's not easy to see. You can see the here it's recurrence, the country where the sample is fine, and the name of the provider. So I have all this information, and I can follow all the attacker made. And all sample I downloaded from Tor to be have a kind of anonymously. I will make an example after that. I will show you the bot after. So here it's a tracker. So I exported all the data from on the web page on my blog, it's the address. So here it's the same data you can see on my bot. So this is the address of the first scene of the sample. Here it is the sample, the drop site of the sample, the type of the malware, it's Hachime, the hash and the country and the provider name. And I have developed a malware plugin too. The malware plugin is quite useful because it's able to reverse automatically the sample. You have to put the command line the slash malware and the drop site. It will download the sample, footer again, and the sample is parsed from the YARA rules. And the YARA rules identify the sample and return the hash, MD5 hash, and it decrypts the configuration. As you can see, it's a XOR DDoS. So it just made the Python script just made XOR, of course, and it decrypts the configuration. Okay. After because made just a reversing of Linux malware, it's become boring. I start to make a automatic reversing of Windows malware. So I have developed the Unpack malware, Unpack some plugin. Most of the time, the malware from Windows or Linux are packed. It's rarely on Linux, but it's open often in Windows. So I have developed the Unpack plugins. So the Unpack plugins, you as before, you put the drop site. It's hard to see again. It's a Dark Comet UPX sample. It's packed by UPX. And the Unpack plugin download the sample from Tor. It passed from Yarul. Yarul identified a UPX sample. It unpack it. It return it's dark. The unpacked sample is a Dark Comet. It return the MDSA5 again, and it return you the unpacked sample. You can download it, and it re-equip the configuration. Here you can see the CC address of the Dark Comet malware. So after that, I developed another plugins that can be useful if you do some incident response or in your job on forensic, but more useful in incident response. So malware and unpack, slash Yara if you just want to identify the sample. A Shodan if you want to if you want to get information from the CC address, for example, if you want to know the open port or what is this address come from, is what country is it, or what provider is it behind, whatever, you can use a slash IP address, slash IP plugin. Also the same, give you information about the IP address, VT. You can put a hash on the VT plugin, and it will return you the VT results, VT analysis of the sample. URL query, if you think URL is malicious, you put this command line and you have the result of the URL query. GSFine, it's Google custom search engine. In Google, you can make your your bot, your search motor. You create Google GSE and you put some URL inside GSE, inside GSE, and the custom engine will only search inside the URL you have put. So it can be cool if you want to search some information about, I don't know, some APT, for example, you put address of the researcher like FireEyes, and you will search only in FireEye website. And the uncertain plugins, if for example, you see a lot of bit.ly URL, and you don't know what is behind this URL, and this plugin will tell you. For example, if you have a bit.ly slash URL, whatever, and behind this URL you think it's a malicious URL, it will say to you. So the plugin, the bot is not perfect. I have just made it for fun and for my personal interest. But some people start to use it, and some people try to download. I forget to say, I also export the log, the malware log I found in the JSON and CSV format. I start to see some people, some cert and whatever, who are interested by this data and try to download it. So start to be useful for other people. So it's cool. I haven't made it just for me and for a few friends, so I'm happy to that. And so I want to make the bot better. I start to search some ID to what can I prove my bot. So I have some ID in my head. So for example, there is a bug. It's not a bug, it's a functionality. It's missed in Telegram backend of Airbot. You cannot download the sample directly from the chat. I want to just copy paste the sample inside the chat room, and I want the bot download it directly. For the moment, I cannot. That's why I always say URL, so it's a bit boring. So normally it will fix in few don't know, maybe day or month, probably more, but a month in Telegram. Some developer start to made it, and I want to support also more Packer and malware, but I know it's impossible to support all Packer and all malware, but I want to bend some script and to, for example, for a campaign, if there is a campaign like a Wiso or like a Dridex, I want to make a script and put the script inside the bot, and after I will not have to reverse another Dridex sample. And I wanted to auto-reverse through a Windows VM. That can be complicated to do it, because I need also a Windows VM, but I want to my bot launch command line inside the Windows and use, for example, a WinDBG script to reverse or unpack some malware. I start to make some tests to do that. I think it's possible, but it will take some time. And I use another bot inside my on my job, and I think it's possible to integrate it with a CM. If you export some data to the CM, for example, in JSON format, I don't know, for example, the data from what all users have downloaded in a JSON format, you can parse it from the bot, and the bot can help you to identify if it's a legit download, if it's a malware or not, or if it's legit. It can be useful to automate these things, and you will not have to do it by hand, and because it's so boring. And I wanted to share the sample to MISP. There is a Python module for MISP. I start to make plugin to share the sample to MISP too. So yeah. So I don't know if you have some questions or ideas.
So yeah, the idea of this talk was to have a short presentation and then generate discussion based on the presentation. So if you are still thinking about question, I will start then. So have you thought about developing a plugin that could potentially send the sample to Cuckoo Sandbox, for instance, or other sandbox platform so that we can get the result from it?
Yeah, I forget to tell about this. When the malware plugin finds a new sample, it's automatically uploaded to VirusTotal website and to Linux Malware Hunter. It's a Cuckoo sandbox made by our friends, and it's automatically uploaded to his website.
Not sure, maybe if you mentioned, but do you know if it's already possible, or if maybe it's something that you plan to develop, like to interact, like sending commands like to the bot to decide like what type of analysis you want to do, for example, is something like that is available, or you think you plan to do, like you upload a certain sample and you want to do a certain type of analysis, or maybe you don't want to automatically upload the virus total, so you send the sample to the bot and then you say do this and this.
Ah yeah, but it's not. It will do automatically. So for the moment, I cannot have a choice if I don't want to the sample is uploaded to VirusTotal or to the Linux sandbox. So it's automatically do. But as I say, developing plugin to Airbot just Python, you can put an option and it's easy to change it. For the moment, my plugins are not on GitHub, but it's not. Public, but I will push it soon. I have just to put some summary commentary inside the plugin because I'm not a very strong Python guy, so the code is a bit dirty. So I have to clean it and put some summary, and after I will push it on my GitHub.
Okay, I'll continue then. You were speaking about potentially automating the reversing in Windows VM, which I think is quite hard. But have you thought about already having generic unpacking identification, like identifying all the call to virtual alloc, for instance, so that you can give them to the reverser, saying, okay, those are the interesting addresses in memory that you should look for unpacking if it's not already known unpacking standard. Yeah, so basically identifying the call to virtual alloc, for instance, you know, because they first will call that to allocate memory, copy the stuff there, and then decrypt and unpack.
Yeah, I think it's possible. With WinDBG, if you made a script which made a breakpoint on virtual alloc, for example, or an write memory address, if you put a breakpoint on it, you can retrieve the what is right inside the memory chunk, and you can get an unpacked sample. Yeah, but it's run only for a generic unpacker. There is no solution for all the packer. It's impossible.
Then, okay, tough question. Can you please make us a demo of automated unpacking and all the stuff you have implemented?
You will saw my private chat, but doesn't matter. I have also a plugin inside Telegram. You can it's auto. Don't remember his name. It's auto. Remember his name. Auto cybercrime maybe. And it retrieve some IOC sharing on the public platform like cybercrime or Alien Vault or whatever. And you can see some CC address like Pony. It's able to identify the Pony version. Here you have a Pony, here you have a Stealer. I don't know if it's possible. Yeah, so most of the time you find some Pony malware. It's the Pony's source code is on GitHub, so it's one of the most used malware. So let's start to show a demo. We haven't made a mistake. It will run. Oh, no. Okay, now it's run. So yeah, so I have put some sample on my website. It's a dark comet, as you see in my previous slide. So we have downloaded it and identified it by Yaya Raoul. So the packer is UPX. Here, this is the MD5 of the sample. The unpacked sample is here. You can download it by if you click on it. It's a dark comet. Here's the MD5, and here you have the configuration, decrypted configuration. You can have more information. For example, if you use the MD5 of the sample, sometimes it can belong, so you have to call VT. Interface, so it will happen soon. Hurry up. If it will, yeah. Okay. So the sample is on VT. So it's identified. The output is a bit dirty due to the limitation of the message on the Telegram. So yeah, as you can see, for example, Avast identified by GenMalicious. But it's always a generic name for the antivirus provider. It's always a mess. So, yeah. Donc, normally, it's, maybe there is one who identify it correctly as a dark comet. No. 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 Ah, si, this one. Clamavi. identify it correctly. Nano antivirus too. Tencent. Okay. Not a lot, as you can see. Eh? So if you are, if you made some time a day malware analysis, you will see identifying a malware from antivirus is always a mess. Try. Oops. No. Right. Shodan plugin is a bit slow too. Go, go, go. When you want. So normally it will, the output will be the number, the port number open to the CC address. I don't know what's happened. The demo effect. No, you don't want to do. Okay. Okay, bon. Try to another one to see if the plugin run. Okay, bon. Maybe there is a problem with your other address. Maybe the URL has removed, I don't know. So as you can see, there is just a port for free. The DNS port is open to the 8888 address. Normal, it's the Google DNS. Oh, sorry for the CC address, but okay, it's one for the other one. Okay. Another question?
Okay, so maybe last question before we go with next talk is, how are you feeling about hosting malware on your own website?
I will remove it soon.
Okay, so thank you very much. Nice demo, and thank you for being here.